I wanted to show you guys how I start a new behavior with my dogs. And I'm gonna use Gypsy, and she already has an obedience title from her first owner. So she's very easy to work with. So have realistic expectations of your own dogs. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna retrain her the place command, because now that I have three dogs, these are a little bit big and they kind of get in the way and they're kind of expensive to buy a third one. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to change all of the dogs over to sitting inside of a circle. Usually if a dog knows that there's a border that they aren't supposed to cross, then they will usually stay inside of that border. You just have to clearly define where it is you want your dog to sit, whether it be with something like this or using something like this. When I feed my dogs, they all have to sit on a mat that's right outside my kitchen. And they all have to sit there and wait while I prepare their food, especially in the evenings, because they do get soft food in the evenings. So I'm gonna put this back and I'm gonna try to get Gypsy's attention and we'll see how this goes. This is kind of an experiment. I've never taught a dog this before. So, and excuse my messy garage. I'm still working on my little garage project. I'm gonna go ahead, put this down. And I'm gonna get Gypsy's. Come on, Chip. All right. So I learned this on Learberg. This is where I learned this particular technique. And I only make a point of saying where I learned things because dogs are like people. There's so many different ways to teach someone something. So the dogs are the same way. So this might not work for you. So you might need to go to another professional and seek out a different way of doing things. So I learned this from Learberg. Here's a little treat. It's about the size of a pea. I like to use Happy Howies because their treats, they A, hold together a little bit better, and B, they're a little bit oily, so I get some of the smell on my hand, and I kind of use that when I try to fade out a treat. So anyway, so here we go. Chippy, chip, 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 chip. Come on. Good girl. Come on. So I'm going to start the behavior. You wait right there. I start the behavior just by luring her into a position that I want her in. And it's going to take a little while before I put a command to it. So it's going to be sped up a little bit. And I really hate that it is. It'll probably be slower with Oliver. But I wanted to give you guys a sneak peek of what I'm doing here. So, okay, we're gonna give her the treats. Come on. There we go. Thank you. another way that you can do this is, get her in there, that you can do this is make it into a food game. And one of the food games that you can use is toss the treat. Whee, there you go. She's likely gonna come back. And she already knows an automatic sit from her first owner. So I'm cheating a little bit. Dogs aren't stupid. They are going to do whatever it is that works out in their favor. And it's their favor to hang out with us. So a lot of times they want to learn so they can keep hanging out with us. And Gypsy also, she knows touch pads, so it's gonna be a little bit quicker for her to come back to me. Good girl. So that's about it. I hope you guys can see that all well enough. I'm gonna do another video of me changing Kojak, that's my red dog, and then Oliver, he's the little smaller cattle dog that I have. He's the puppy that probably everybody loves to see. But this is, and I hope I can get her to look at you guys. Come on, Jack. Beep, 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 beep. This is Gypsy. And I'll put a photo of her. I'll put a photo of her with my thumbnail. So this is Gypsy, and she's a beautiful 9-year-old cattle dog. Chew. Yes. And she is bred to be a pet. You're gonna notice that all of my cattle dogs, they all look very different, even though they're the same breed. They were all bred for different purposes by their breeder. So they're all gonna look different. And that's something else I want to talk about later as well, is purpose breeding. So I hope everybody has a good rest of their 4th of July weekend. And hopefully I do a good job editing this because I don't have my computer. So everybody have a good 4th of July. Bye.